burning of ancient Aztec texts, and he was surprised to note the reaction of the locals to this order. He said, "We found a large number of books in these characters, these Aztec characters, and as they contained nothing in which were not to be seen as superstition and lies to the devil, we burned them all, which they, the Maya, regretted to an amazing degree, and which caused them much affliction." I wonder why you're burning their ancient texts. Why on earth would they get angry about this? During the burning of Washington in the War of 1812, remember that one? The British used 3,000 books from the U.S. Library of Congress as kindling to help burn down the U.S. Capitol building. Do you get taught that in American school these days? I'm not sure. The New York Society for the Suppression of Vice, which was founded by anti-vice advocate Anthony Comstock in 1873 as a self-appointed guardian of public morality, actually considered book burning to be such a valuable part of the work that they did that they put an image of a man burning books on their official seal. Not as a warning, or not as some sort of, this is a dystopian nightmare. No, they did that as, this is what we aspire to. We will burn all those bad books that you shouldn't be reading. And, of course, the paradigmatic example of our times, the Nazis, of course, did engage in book burning of un-German books in their attempt to protect the value, the vulnerable, fragile German mind from information that the Nazi regime did not personally approve of. It has been understood for decades, centuries, millennia, that when dictators try to seize ultimate control of a population, one of the first things they do is burn books that contains information that go against their rule. So this is not some sort of vague or abstract thing that we should be kind of a little bit hesitant about. No, this is something we should be very concerned about. And one person who is concerned is someone that I think is perhaps the philosopher of this new age that we're living in, the age of biosecurity, coming on the heels of the age of homeland security, Giorgio Agamben, the Italian philosopher, who wrote in one of his recent writings, "I do not know if bonfires will return and books will be put on the index, but clearly the thought of those who continue to seek the truth and reject the dominant lie will be, as is already happening before our eyes, excluded and accused of spreading fake news." News, not ideas, because news is more important than reality. "As in all moments of emergency, real or simulated, we see once again the ignorant slander philosophers and scoundrels seeking to profit from the disasters that they themselves have provoked. All this has already happened and will continue to happen, but those who testify to the truth will not stop doing so, because no one can bear witness for the witness." And that is what we are doing. We are bearing witness to what is happening and attempting to leave a record in the Library of Alexandria of those things that are happening. So it is not surprising that the people who are perpetrating acts like 9/11 would want that information to be scrubbed from that library. And this is, again, a type of dystopia that has been warned about for a very long time. People might be thinking of this in a literary context. Fahrenheit 451 by Ray Bradbury, and I'm sure a lot of people are familiar with that book, but for those who are not, in Fahrenheit 451, Bradbury imagines a world in which books are banned, and firemen are not people who rush into burning buildings to save them from the fire and to put out the fire. No, firemen are people who rush into burning buildings in order to, or who rush into buildings in order to burn books. If there are books found anywhere, these firemen are called to the scene, spray it with kerosene, and light the match to make sure those books are burnt. In fact, the official slogan of the firemen in Fahrenheit 451 is, "Burn them to ashes, then burn the ashes." And the protagonist of the story, who starts as just one of those firemen, says at near the beginning of the story, "Kerosene is nothing but perfume to me." And Bradbury paints a very vivid picture of exactly why a dystopian nightmare dictatorial society of the future would want to burn books. For example, the fire captain in this story, Montag's boss, Fire Captain Beatty, says, "A book is a loaded gun in the house next door. Burn it. Take the shot from the weapon. Breach man's mind. Who knows who might be the target of the well-read man?" And he goes on later in the story to say, "What is fire? It's a mystery. scientists give us gobbledygook about friction and molecules, but they don't really know. Its real beauty is that it destroys responsibility and consequences. A problem gets too burdensome, then into the furnace with it. It is a nightmare to live in a society where the public can be so thoroughly controlled by controlling its access to information.